A very good morning and a beautiful day that the Lord has given us. What an awesome day that the Lord has given us the gift and the breath of life, that we may be able to find His grace and blessing. But also we know that every day that the Lord gives us, He gives us with a purpose. Because even every blessing that the Lord has blessed us with, He has an agenda. He has an agenda with your life, has an agenda with your good health, has an agenda with the career and the employment He is giving you, an agenda with the business that you are doing, has an agenda with the family that He has given you to raise, has an agenda about the gifting and the talents that He has bestowed on you. God has an agenda even of giving us this opportunity, even to be men and women who also seek the face of God and the Word of God. And therefore, brethren, I welcome you even as we share the Word of God this morning. Remember, we have started a journey from yesterday, and this is the new journey of the steps on how we obtain God's salvation. And I want to thank God so much that after we are able to pick and understand the basis of salvation, that yesterday we were able to start the journey of understanding and how do we obtain this great and marvelous salvation. And yesterday we said, number one, we must admit that and acknowledge that we are all sinners. We have fallen short of the glory of God. And therefore, when we accept that we are sinners, then we are willing to find and to look for help. And the help of sin is only found on Jesus. And we take the second step of repentance. And we accept, we said yesterday, we must be penitent, a repentant that is sincere from the heart. And today, I want us to go to the next level. And the next level is the wisdom of confession. The wisdom of confession. And this is the next step of being able to obtain the salvation of the Lord. Let me read from the book of Romans chapter 10 and verses 10. This is what the Bible says. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you confess your faith and are saved. As the scripture says, anyone who believes in Him will never be put to shame. Hallelujah. You know, brethren, salvation is about confession, because we believe and we are justified. We confess and we find God's salvation. In other words, when we confess, we are born again. And I want to remind us that one of the most important things, confession, it is admitting of our guilt. And when we admit of our guilt, in other words, we accept that we are charged. And that the way we are charged, we are guilty as charged. And when we realize that, we repent of our sins. When we repent of our sins, we confess of our sins. Confession is a very important thing. Confessing, you know, I have also realized that there is power in words. Not only that realizing it, but the Bible says, and the Bible says, you remember in the book of Job, it says, and you shall decree a thing and it shall come to pass. There is power on the things that we decree and talk with our mouths. Because in our tongue, there is life and death. And that's why we are supposed to be careful about the things we confess about ourselves. You know, there are people who confess about who they are. They confess that they are weak. They confess their weaknesses, confess their inability, confess of how they cannot. I know you have ever met with people that every time they have a kind of timid spirit, every time they talk about negativity, what is not possible, they talk about a lot of impossibilities. It is important to confess important and the right things about your life. It's good to confess that even on this time of coronavirus, that we are not going to die. We shall live and be the remnant that will be talking about the goodness of the Lord, even the years to come. It is good to confess that all our members of our families will live to tell of the glory of God. It is good to confess that we are not going to be poor because of the economy, but the Lord will continue to meet all our needs according to His riches in glory. It is good to confess that we are going to find God's grace, because the Bible says, I will bless your bread and water and I will remove sickness from among you. It is good to confess that we are not in the hands of men. Our lives, our destiny is not in the hands of men, because the Bible says, for I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, to give you a future that is full of hope. Haven't you forgotten, brethren, it's good also to confess that we know that our God and our Redeemer liveth. That even if whatever happens in life, even those people who are sick and are watching and they are also nursing sick people, it is good to let you know that even when these people go through the valley of the shadow of death, they will be able to be safe, because it's God who is our God. He is our Redeemer. And because He is alive, we can be able to face tomorrow with courage. And therefore, confession is very, very important. Even in salvation, it's good to confess. When we confess, we are able to find salvation. Because when we believe, we are justified. When we confess, we find God's salvation. And the other step that is important I want to share today is the step number four, is the step of forsaking. Now, when we talk about forsaking, it is about giving up. Now, you know the Bible says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So when I talk about forsaking, it is reminding you that when you say that I will never leave you nor forsake you, the Bible is telling us that God is saying, I will never give up on you. But now, on this particular step, one of the most important things that we remember, we need to learn to forsake. After we have accepted and confessed, and we have received the grace of God, of the forgiveness of our sins, we must also learn the next step that is important, to forsake our old life. You know what the Bible says? It says, and behold, the old has gone and the new has come. In other words, those who are in Christ Jesus, those people who have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ in their life, it is important that they learn that the old has gone, the new has come. When you talk about the new has come, it is reminds us the wisdom of forsaking the olden patterns of life. A story is told of a gentleman, a very interesting gentleman, and he had a challenge of drinking, and when he decided to come to Christ, and he decided that he's coming to the church, he came one Sunday morning, and he was able to tell the priest that now I want to stop my past life of drinking and whatever, and I want to come to church. And he was told that that is a very good thing, and therefore you are welcome even to the church of Jesus Christ. And then a baptism was prepared, and when he came, he asked, now which name do you choose for me? And he told me, I want you to be called Andrew. And you know, from where we come from our culture, when you're talking about Andrew, you say Andrea. Now, Andrea is like a name that can be confused to say continuation. So when the guy was baptized, and then it's like he heard that the priest called him Andrea, when he went back, and then it's like he started and following his normal life, he went and took two or three, and then he met with an elder of the church, and he was staggering, and he told him, why are you not baptized? What's wrong that you are continuing with the life that you have been? And he said, no, you know, the pastor, the priest baptized me and called me Andrea. So you know what I decided? I think he gave me the okay to continue and endelea. And you know, that is the mistake that we do when we are able to take the step of acknowledgement, the step of repentance, and when we take the step of confession, then we fail on taking the step of forsaking, turning away from the olden, evil, wicked ways. Brethren, we cannot be able to move and obtain fullness of God's salvation unless we accept to be able to forsake. That's why Jesus says and calls and tells the disciples that unless you forsake your life, in other words, unless you deny yourself and carry your cross, you cannot be able to follow Jesus. Whoever would want to follow Christ must deny himself and fall and carry his cross. Do you know what it means to deny? To deny yourself is to sacrifice the patterns, the passions of this life, and be willing to die on the past wicked and sinful life, and be able to carry in yourself the burden of righteousness and of following Christ faithfully, so that you may be able to make steps to obtain the fullness and the blessing of God's salvation. I want to encourage us this morning, brethren. Is there anything that you feel that you have been carrying from the past life? Are you carrying anger? Are you carrying bitterness? Are you carrying unforgiveness? Are you carrying pride of any kind? Are you carrying any manner of spiritual or sexual immorality? Are you finding yourself in one way or another becoming someone who is becoming selfish, and even sometimes you become jealous? Are you carrying in your life and in your spirit even a spirit of feeling that you are the spirit of deserving, that you feel that is like you deserve more than others? And that was called selfishness. May the Lord help us. Because God is calling us that we may be able, by God's grace in this step, to forsake the olden patterns of sin. That's what Paul calls the fruit of the flesh. And we are able to carry in us the fruit of the Spirit. That all those things that are evil and sinful, we are able to turn away from them. Giving up on sin, giving up on wickedness, giving up on the life of sin and evil, and being by God's grace, be willing that we may be able to receive the grace of God on issues of living a new life. Allow me also to mention to you that in the book of Isaiah, let me read to you in the book of Isaiah so that I can make it even more clear. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, Isaiah chapter 55, and I want to read from Isaiah 55 and verses 7. This is what the Bible says. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord, and he will have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will freely pardon. You see, that is a wonderful call. A call of forsaking and abandoning. And you know what the Bible says here? Forsaking the ways of wickedness. Forsaking the ways and the life of unrighteousness. And righteousness of their thoughts. And let me tell you, one of the things that we should remember, that wickedness and sinful things are, by the way, in our thoughts, the way we think, by the way we act, the way we do things, and also the way, by the way, even the way in one way or another, not only the thinking and doing, even the way we keep ourselves from doing what is right. You know, it's amazing that even refusing to do what is right, and you know it is right, it is a sin. And by the way, it's also good to say, it's not only about our thoughts, it is not only about what we act, even the way we talk, the things we say. By the way, we are supposed to be careful that every word that comes from our mouth, you know, the Bible says from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So the way we talk and the kind of talks we speak, they talk about who we are in the spirit and in our souls. And therefore, we need to forsake every wicked thought, every unrighteous thought, every act, or everything that at least is words that are not right and are not holy. We are supposed to forsake them. And forsaking, we said, we give up on them. But also we have given up on them. I'm happy because Isaiah is saying, it is not only giving up, but we must also do something about it. What do we need to do? We need to seek God's mercy. Say, then we turn to the Lord. We forsake the evil. We turn to the Lord. And when we turn to the Lord, what happens? We have mercy. And we receive mercy, the mercy of God. And God will freely, by his grace, pardon us. And in this case, remember, we have the one who accepted to die for our sins. And his name is our Lord Jesus Christ. And we talked about and said, he is our atonement lamb. He is the one who redeemed us, who stood on our behalf, that we may be able to find God's salvation. May we turn to Jesus this morning, and about every manner of evil, anything that in one way or another we have not been able to forsake, let us turn away from these kind of things, and let us learn to Jesus and seek for his mercy, and he will freely pardon us. And you know, when he pardons us and when he forgives our sins, they are forgiven, because his sacrifice, it is enough, it is acceptable, it is holy, and above all, it is final, because he has died for us and he said, it is finished. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord do you good, even as we continue to obtain God's salvation, even by confession and also by God's grace, forsaking every manner of evil and turning to God. Father, we thank you so much for the gift of life, the gift of salvation that you give to us through your Son, Jesus Christ. Teach us on how to continue to accept and take accountability of our sins and confess them. And Father, give us the grace to forsake every manner of evil. And as we do that today, O Lord, may we freely find your grace and mercy, and may find God's salvation. We pray for this day, that you cause this day and this week to be a blessing. Bless the work of our hands. Bless our going out and our coming in. Shield us and guard us from every manner of evil. Heal us, O God. And Father, continue to restore our lives and our health. And also we pray, may your blessings and presence continue to be with us. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.